Empire Enterprises has been accused of perpetuating violence. Do you think that the misogyny and celebration of gang warfare that's so prevalent in hip-hop music is healthy for our nation?
Well, anything that expresses the First Amendment is healthy for our country. If artists are supposed to thrive, they need to have the freedom of speech.
Right, yeah, you have mentioned that many times before.
Let's go. Let's get out of here.
Ms. Lyons, do you have any comments on the Kid Fofo controversy?
I got plenty of comments.
Apparently, one of your associates would like to make a comment on that issue.
Kid Fofo's Tide rhymes ain't nothing compared to what Lucius Lyon used to spit back in the day. The same man who used to sing, "The cops deny freedom for life. I ain't afraid to kill one to defend my wife."
Your own lyrics are even more inciting than the ones that you're defending. Do you disagree?
Everyone has a closet.
My music expresses my world. That's how I grew up. Where you either sold drugs or you watched your children go hungry. Where half of your family is locked off in prison. Our music is more of a narration of an oppressed people. You see, the Empire artists are telling the next generation that even though they live in a world where Trayvon Martin can get shot down like a dog without...
The closest people to you can try.
How does it give them hope if all the songs do is promote more violence?
Well, there's hope in the fact that these kids are expressing their anger with music and poetry and not with a 12-gauge shotgun.
Do you feel that you can still speak to these kids, even though you're now living in penthouses and yachts?
I try to talk to my sons. I don't think they're listening to me.
Tell the truth.
Maybe it's me that's not listening to them.